Hello everyone, you might know this feeling. You watch a tutorial on YouTube and there's a parameter set in the code which you don't understand, and it also doesn't get explained in the video. And you think to yourself, ah, okay, maybe it's not that important because you're kinda too lazy to go to the documentation and look it up yourself. This happened to me with the parameter chain type here, and in the tutorial he wrote in stuff. I thought to myself, stuff? What was he mean with stuff? Can I write in the parameter everything I want? Just some random stuff? Or what does it mean? And then I saw it in another tutorial, and at that time I knew, okay, maybe it's time to look into it. Maybe you saw the same parameter, maybe you wanna know what it is. I'm gonna explain it to you. So there are a couple of chains where you see it in length chain. For the load summarize chain and the load QA chain, for example, you can set it to stuff, map, reduce and refine. This parameter occurs at points where you're working with documents that might be very large. I made an example here. We're working with GPT 3.5 Turbo. So the context size is 4000. I have here the transcript of a YouTube video. The token size is 6000 if you're treating it as a single document, so that's way too large for ChatGPT since the context window is 4000. And here is it, it's chunked up in three documents. The first method, stuffing, so stuff is just an abbreviation of stuffing because you stuff in the whole document at once. For every method you will see prompt templates defined, but actually if you don't want something specific, then you don't have to define it yourself because they already defined the default template. And also, that's another tip. Sometimes I have a hard time with documentations, then I just jump into the code on GitHub and just look into the code. There you can find your answers. That's the source of truth, so to speak. We load the summarize chain, put stuff for stuffing. So we stuff the complete text, the complete document in there. We're going to run it, and then it ran into an error. The model's maximum content length is 4000. Your message is 6000. It couldn't summarize it. But what's the advantage of stuffing? Well, that you only have to do one API call and the model gets the whole text as input and can provide a concise summary. The disadvantage, you have to work within the range of the context window. Okay, the next method, the MapReduce method, you provide different chunks of the document, and the MapReduce method will summarize each chunk, then provide the summary of each chunk as a new input to the model, and then summarize the summaries. Let's try it out. Load summary chain, chain type MapReduce, and then we have obviously to input the documents here. The first chunk, write a summary of this chunk of text, then the next chunk of text, there's the third chunk. The chunks get imported one after another into the LLM, and now write a concise summary of the following, which are the summaries that got outputted before, and here's the bullet point summary. Okay, what are the advantages? You can overcome the context limit from the stuffing method, and you can make asynchronous calls, so each chunk doesn't have to be called after another but parallel, and the summary is faster. But you potentially lose context between the chunks because the chunk is kinda taken out of context, so that might be a disadvantage here. But there's another method, the refine method, which tackles this problem. It summarizes the chunks after another, and to each subsequent call provides a summary from the previous chunk. The prompt template says, please refine this summary with the next chunk. If you want something specific, use a prompt template and customize. You could do, for example, something like summarize in Spanish, but the base prompt templates are sufficient enough. Yeah, and there we can see the steps. First chunk, write a concise summary of the following. Okay, then it output the summary. Here's the summary from the previous step. Here's the next input. There, step by step, it will expand the summary until you have the final summary. Okay, the video discussed the importance of building a solid knowledge base for chatbots and AI automation agencies. If I look at it, the summary is really small. So, well, it's in the prompt template to write a concise summary. Maybe it would be better to refine this prompt so that the summary would be a little bit greater. I mean, that was a 20-minute YouTube video. Just a handful of sentences to summarize it. It's kinda not enough. I would need more information. But that's another topic, the topic for my next video, where we're going to talk about how to summarize YouTube videos. So here, the advantages are that you might have more context than MapReduce because you're forwarding the summary to this point. But the disadvantage is that you cannot call it parallelized, so you have to make subsequent calls because each call is dependent on a summary from the previous step, obviously. And this method might suffer from recency bias, so the output might be tailored more to the last chunks. This is something to keep in mind. I would say if you can work within the context size, just use the stuff method. If not, you might want to use the MapReduce method with the ability to parallelize it. It depends on how fast you need the outputs, I'd say. The refine method is also fine. I hope I could help you with this video. Thank you for watching. Click the subscribe button and see you in another video.